This video is going to be pretty math heavy. Since you asked for it, don't fall asleep or click away. When you hold the human flag position, there are two main physics conditions that are required. First, the upward force coming from the bar needs to be the equivalent to the body weight. Let's say you push the bar with your bottom hand with force F. Due to Newton's third law, which is the law of action and reaction, it states that when two bodies interact, they apply forces to each other equal in magnitude and opposite in direction, which means the bar will give us an opposite force with the same magnitude F. Similarly, when you pull the bar with your upper hand with force F, the bar will give us back an opposite force with the same magnitude F. Now we can simply extract the upward portion of these two forces from the bar by multiplying a cosine theta. The sum of these two needs to be the same as your body weight. This is not the only physics condition that needs to be satisfied. Otherwise, according to this equation, the smaller the theta is, the easier the human flag will be since less force will be required to be generated by the arms. However, there's a reason why we have never seen someone do something like a human flag iron cross to make theta completely zero. It is because there's a second physics condition that needs to be satisfied, which is that the net torque for both points of contact between two bodies should be equal to zero. The definition of a torque is the moment arm times the effective force. The effective force is the force perpendicular to the moment arm. As you can intuitively see, if the force is parallel to the moment arm, it won't cause the object to rotate. Let's take a look at the point of contact at the upper hand. The force the bar gives at the upper hand directly goes through the point of contact, so the torque is zero. As for the force the bar gives at the bottom hand, the effective force is F times sine theta, and the moment arm is the distance between your two arms. So the torque from the bottom hand is F sine theta times the distance between your two arms in the counterclockwise direction. Now let's take a look at the opposing torque in the clockwise direction from our body weight. The effective force is our body weight times cosine phi, and the moment arm is the distance between your center of mass to the upper hand. So the torque from the body weight is body weight cosine phi times the distance between your center of mass and the upper hand. The magnitude of two torques should be exactly the same and cancel each other out. Otherwise, you will be spinning around. Since the body is symmetric, the equation will be exactly the same if we look at the point of contact at the bottom hand. In order to further understand it, we need to plug in some real numbers. All the numbers in these equations can be easily measured except the location of your center of mass. Fortunately, I did a DEXA scan. Therefore, I have a pretty good estimate of where my center of mass is. I'm not going to repeat how to calculate the center of mass in this video. If you are unclear about how the calculation is done, you can check out my previous front lever DEXA scan video. Alright, this is what it looks like if I plug in the real numbers from my DEXA scan data and generate a plot for the first physics condition. The x-axis is the angle between the arm and the bar, which is theta. The y-axis is the force you have to generate in terms of body weight multiplier, which is F. As you can see, the smaller the angle is, the easier it will be to meet the first physics condition. However, if I generate a plot for the second physics condition, you can see that both large angles and small angles will make the human flag difficult. It's the medium angle that makes the human flag the easiest, which is no surprise because everyone who can do the human flag does it with a medium angle. Now I can simply combine these two plots and get the overall strength requirement for me to do the human flag at various angles. According to the plot, the easiest angle for me would be at 41 degrees, which is exactly the angle I had when I achieve the human flag. And the strength requirement for me at 41 degrees is to push and pull 0.86 times of my body weight. I know what you are thinking. You might think that generating this amount of force per arm doesn't sound easy at all. It's actually not that hard. First of all, we are talking about straight arm strength here instead of bent arm strength. For the pulling portion, you don't have to be able to do a one arm pull up. All you need to do is be able to hang with one arm on the bar for 5 seconds. If you can, congratulations! You just smashed the 0.86 times of body weight strength requirement for the straight arm pull. Similarly, for the pushing portion, if you can do a wall assisting one arm handstand for 5 seconds, congratulations! You just smashed the 0.86 times of body weight strength requirement for the straight arm push. I know some of you are gonna say, but the wall must have taken out some weight during the one arm handstand. Yes, but the wall actually only takes out around 3% of the body weight. The main purpose of the wall is not to take out weight, but to let you not have to worry about balance, which is the main difficulty of the handstand. Additionally, if you can't hold a full wall-assisted one-arm handstand, but you can hold it with the fingertips of the other hand on the ground, chances are pretty high that you will still meet the strength requirement for the straight arm push as well. Therefore, if you can hang on a bar with one arm for 5 seconds, and also do a wall-assisted one-arm handstand with the fingertips of the other hand on the ground for 5 seconds, you have the strength to do the human flag. From my point of view, these strength requirements are probably even easier to meet than the bent arm pull strength required for the muscle up. Now it's time to play a game of true or false on some statements about the human flag. Number 1. It's harder for people with long arms to do the human flag. This is absolutely false. If I increase the length of my arms by 10 centimeters and plot the physics requirement graph again, you can see that I can simply decrease the angle to 39 degrees, and the push and pull strength requirement will drop down to 0.82 times of my body weight. Number 2. If you spread your arms as wide as possible, it will be easier to do the human flag. I heard this repeated a few times in popular human flag tutorials, but by now, you should know that this is obviously false. Spreading the arms wide means theta will become smaller. The human flag is very difficult to perform when theta is too small. Number 3. Big hypertrophied upper body muscles will make the human flag easier. This is actually only somewhat true. If I add 20 pounds to my upper body and plot the physics requirement graph again, the easiest angle would become 40 degrees, and the push and pull strength requirement will drop down to 0.84 times of my body weight. However, if we factor in the allometric scaling, which I covered in great detail in my previous video, the difficulty of a 154-pound guy generating force equal to 0.84 times of body weight might not be necessarily easier than the 134-pound guy generating force equal to 0.86 times of body weight. It depends on how much of these extra 20 pounds are muscles that can generate force for the human flag. Sorry guys, big beautiful muscles give you a gigantic advantage for the front lever, but there is barely any for the human flag. Number 4. Taller guys will have a more difficult time learning the human flag. Yes, this is true, but it's not because of physics. If I increase my height to 6 feet and keep the proportion of my body exactly the same, the physics requirement graph will be exactly the same. However, again, due to allometric scaling, the 6 feet version of me will have a harder time pushing and pulling 0.86 times of body weight than the current me pushing and pulling 0.86 times of body weight. Taller guys will have a more difficult time not only in the human flag, but also in calisthenics in general. I also want to give my take on a question that everyone cares the most, which is, how should you actually train for the human flag? As I've mentioned in my previous human flag video, conventional training ideas fall into three main lines of thought: using the resistance band, training tuck variations, and training dynamics. I explained why I don't like any of them in my previous human flag video. Common sense tells me that lacking straight arm pull strength is what the bottleneck will likely be, instead of straight arm pull strength. Therefore, I believe the best exercise to train for the human flag is, you got it, wall-assisted one-arm handstand with as minimal assistance from the other hand as possible, and eventually work your way towards with only the fingertips of the other hand on the ground. Once you can perform this reliably for 5 seconds, you should be able to perform the straddle human flag, bypass all the dubious training methods, and start getting your body to be used to being in the sideways position. Full disclaimer, my take is only based on logic and physics. I don't have any empirical experience to back it up. I was fortunate enough to be able to do the straddle human flag immediately once I get the technique down. So if some of you decide to try training the wall assisted one-arm handstand for the human flag, let me know how it goes. I'm curious to know whether or not it works for you. Lastly, there's one last nuance that I want to point out. When we look at the physics requirement graph, there is an assumption that the difficulty of generating force in all theta is roughly the same. This is venturing into biomechanics territory, which I'm not an expert in. But based on my intuition and experience, I am fairly confident that this assumption is true. It feels natural to push overhead, push 45 degrees, push to the side, and so on. In contrast to the front lever, the small angle in between the arms and the torso not only causes the effective force to counter the body weight smaller, moreover, the force you can generate also drastically decreases because of how unnatural pulling is at a smaller angle. In any case, I will stop the front lever talk right here as this video is about the human flag. Thanks for watching. If you don't want to bother doing the math and you want to simply input your DEXA scan data on a website and get your own personalized strength requirement for the human flag, I can easily make it happen because after all, my core competence is software and math instead of climbing and calisthenics. However, I want to see some support from you guys for my latest 5-bar venture. You will not only get awesome healthy premium bars to eat, but also support the channel at the same time. If I see enough support, I'll be happy to spin up the website for free to the public, and 5-bar customers will have early access to beta test it. Make sure to check out the link in the video description below to order some 5 bars. See you in the next video.